container. Need a cover. You need a 500 ml water. Or somewhere 500. See, that one. And then, 2 tablespoons of oil. I'm using a vegetable oil. 1, 2, here. Get your dry yeast. If you don't have a dry yeast, you can use the fresh yeast. But if you don't have it, for example, now I don't have it, so I'm gonna use this, 1/2 of it, 1/2 tablespoon of, or you can put this all. Yeah, put this all, 1 sachet. Stir it. Set aside. Now, we will need a, for this measurement, I need 600 grams of flour. I'm using a to be precise, I'm using a weighing scale. So you see, this is 600 grams. That's 600 grams, see? I love this simple recipe of pizza dough. I learned it from my mother, though. So simple. And let it rest for at least 1 hour. See you later. Cover it. You will know that it's ready for baking. If you will hear the sound, it will open up, and then that's it. See you later. If you don't have any butter, you can use any vegetable oil or any oil, and rub it here where you will be gonna bake your pizza. I don't have this round pan for pizza, but you can use any baking pan. Then just rub it like this.
I love to rub the batter before baking to get a crunchy bottom.
I normally use some of my your tomato sauce or just a ketchup. Any ketchup will work. So I also make some tuna with some corn and the request of my son without ketchup, just some ham and cheese above, and see you later.
Here you go. See you later.
So, here is our finished product. Let's do like this. Let's slice our crunchy, crunchy, crunchy pizza. Slice it while it's still hot. Here we go.